दूसरा जो है दैट इज पैरेलल लाइन। अब इसकी प्रॉपर्टी देखें, लेट्स से टू लाइंस आर पैरेलल, व्हाट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट और फैक्ट अबाउट देम? दे डोंट इंटरसेक्ट, दैट्स अ रॉन्ग पॉइंट। दे मे इंटरसेक्ट, दे मे बी टुगेदर फॉर द एंटायर ड्यूरेशन, फॉर द एंटायर टाइम, दे मे एग्जिस्ट टुगेदर वन अबव द अदर। पैरेलल लाइंस का जो सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशन है दैट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन देम शुड बी कॉन्स्टेंट, राइट? सो डी इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन देम, इट हैज टू बी कॉन्स्टेंट। That's the only definition of parallel lines actually. Distance, if it is not zero, they will never meet. But if it is zero, then they'll meet, right? Who stops these two lines to be together? Why can't they be together also? Hana? So the distance between them can be zero. So they may meet. In fact, they may stay together for the entire life, right? So parallel lines means the distance between two lines should be constant at all points. This is the definition of parallel lines. Okay. Now, this is one thing. The second thing is, suppose there are two lines parallel and one line intersecting. So, we already have situation for two lines intersecting. Here we have three lines, out of which two are parallel and one is intersecting. So, what are the properties that we get from here? Let's say at this point, suppose this angle is A, B, C, D. This angle is E, F, G, H. We already have the properties of A, B, C, D. And hence, we also have the properties of E, F, G, H. Let's identify the properties of these angles with respect to these angles. Look at the shapes. Agar sirf shakal dekho, tohi aapko bahut sare angles equal dikhenge. Kaun kaun se? A, C, E, G. ऑल्सो बी डी एफ एच. अच्छा, यहां पे एक चीज रह गई थी, ये तो हो गया एंगल्स इन अ लाइन, देन वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल, वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल. ध्यान से देखो इसमें क्या होगा, दिस एंगल इज इक्वल टू दिस एंगल, दिस ए इज इक्वल टू सी, सिमिलरली दिस बी इज इक्वल टू डी. सो वेन एवर टू लाइन इंटरसेक्ट, अपोजिट एंगल्स आर इक्वल, आमने सामने वाले जो एंगल्स है वो इक्वल होता है. नाउ यहां पे पैरेलल तो बिल्कुल नहीं लग रहा, सपोज दीज टू लाइंस पैरेलल, वन इज इंटरसेक्टिंग लाइन ए बी सी डी एंड दिस इज ई एफ जी एच. इनका आपस का रिलेशन और इनका आपस का रिलेशन उसमें नहीं जाता है. लेट्स फाइंड आउट रिलेशन बिटवीन दीज एंगल्स एंड दीज एंगल्स, क्या होगा? A इज इक्वल टू ई, परफेक्ट. तो A इज इक्वल टू ई एंड इस तरह के दूसरे भी होंगे, B इक्वल टू एफ, C इक्वल टू जी एंड D इक्वल टू एच. दीज पेयर्स ऑफ एंगल्स आर नोन एज कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स. वेरी गुड, कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग स्पेलिंग देख लेना, कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स समांतर कोण, कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स. Right, so whenever two lines are parallel, one line intersect, the corresponding angles are equal. Okay. उसके बाद दूसरा, look at this angle C and this angle E. Right. So C is equal to E. In fact, we already had A equal to E. We also know that A must be equal to C because of vertically opposite angle. So clearly C is also equal to E. ठीक. So C is equal to E, D equal to F. And A equal to G and B equal to H. Look at the diagram and identify the location, position, relation. Right? Now, these two, in fact, all of them are called alternate angles. Alternate angles. Ekantar ko. Naam pe nahi jaane ka. Position, situation yaad hona chahiye. Kaun sa, kidhar hai, kya relation hai. So, alternate angles. And, these two are called interior alternate angles. Okay. Similarly, these two are called, because they are outside the parallel lines, these two are inside the parallel lines, hence interior. The other two are exterior alternate angles. exterior alternate angles. Alright? Fine. Good. Very good. So, this is just the introduction of lines, angles, parallel lines and their relation. There can be a question like this. Find x. These lines are parallel, L1, L2, L3 are parallel, and this, let's say this is L4 and this is L5, they are parallel. So, L1 is parallel to L2 is parallel to L3 and L4 is parallel to L5. Simple situation. It is a random situation, right? Zabasti ka draw kiya hai, abhi abhi. Some situation is given, some angle is given. One important property jo yaha pe reh gaya tha, kya reh gaya tha? Look at the angles on one line. Look at this A and D. What is their sum? 180. A and D angles on the same line. The sum has to be 180 degree. And we also know that A is equal to E. So that means D plus E equal to 180 degree. So the ek property aur reh gaya, wo bhi likh lijiye, that it is D plus E. How will you define D and E? Angles on the same side of the oblique or transversal, right? Inside. So it is D plus E or C plus F or A plus H or B plus G. All of them are equal to 180 degree. This is a very important property. In fact, ye dono usme, in fact, ye aur ye sab usme lag jate hai na, parallelogram mein properties ban jate hai. ठीक है अभी फिलहाल अरे यार ये पैरेलल लाइन क्यों नहीं बनता बहुत बदमाशी करता है हाँ अभी ठीक है बताइए पॉसिबल नहीं है क्यों क्या हुआ x इक्वल टू 2x+30 हो जाएगा ना जस्ट बाय द शेप ऑफ इट राइट ध्यान से देखो सपोज दिस एंगल इज x Then this angle has to be x. Why? Alternate angles. Because these two lines are parallel and this is intersecting. Right? Now, these two lines are parallel, L4 and L5. L2 is intersecting. So, these two angles should be equal by corresponding angle. Okay? So, by corresponding angles, x equal to 2x+30. So, we get x equal to -30 degree. Right? But by the shape of this, this angle doesn't seem to be -30 degree. But this angle doesn't seem to be -30 degree. -30 degree would actually mean technically 330 degree. Okay. So, this doesn't suit the situation. So don't worry. Aisa question aap se nahi puchhega. Agar main iska position change kar deta hun. Let's say if I have this angle to be 2x+30 degree. Now check it. Janbujhke obviously diya tha. Ek baar check kare pehle. Ab ye wala. Ab solve ho jayega. See, these are all parallel line situation, right? So, this angle is x, then this has to be x, this has to be x, this has to be x, this has to be x. And that's it. Kyun aisa hua? These two are alternate angles. These two are corresponding angles. These two are corresponding angles. These two are corresponding angles. Right? Now, look at this point. These are the angles at one line. Angles at one line, sum kitna hona chahiye? 180 degree. So, we have x plus 2x+30 degree that is equal to 180 degree. So, we have 3x equal to 150 degree and that gives us x equal to 50 degree. Okay? So, this was a simple question. Is tarah se bahut sare question ho sakte hain. Ye sabse favorite area hota hai chote entrance exams ke liye.